What up, roughly? Just welcome back to my channel. Today, I want to talk about the contract with ExxonMobil. And I want to clarify the misinformation that went on during the election cycle that said that Guyana should have signed a royalty-only contract instead of a profit-sharing contract, right? So throughout the election cycle, there was a lot of lies and misinformation that said that Guyana only got 2% from a royalty contract with ExxonMobil and that we should have signed a bigger royalty contract instead. But now that we have data from the first three quarters of 2020, we can now discern the facts, the truth behind the statement. Stay tuned.
This is my day. I'm ready to take it on, come what may.
So throughout the last election cycle, a lot of the opposition parties criticized the leading party, the ruling government, for signing a bad contract with ExxonMobil. They said that Guyana stood to lose hundreds of millions of dollars or billions of dollars, depending on who was reporting, because they signed a profit-sharing contract instead of a royalty contract, right? And then they had a lot of outside commentators hired by the PPPC, right, using Mercury Public Affairs, who were flooding the airwaves and flooding social media with a lot of misinformation and lies and disinformation, saying that Guyana stood to lose $115 million and that the royalty contract is better than a profit-sharing contract. And all these so-called businessmen out there were chiming in, giving their point. If you remember, some well-known accountants also chiming in, saying that Guyana stood to lose so much money because they signed a bad contract with ExxonMobil. Now, all of this is lies, and I actually explained why in the during the election cycle using videos that I published on social media. And I'm going to explain again why these are lies now that we have data from the first three quarters of 2020, right? Guyana has now received payment for three shipments of oil and three quarters of royalty. This amounts to $144.67 million. And what I'm about to prove to you now is that this represents a profit-sharing contract that is superior to any royalty contract we could have signed, because out of the total production in the first three quarters of 2020, Guyana received 14.25% of the profits. All right, so the first year of operation, Guyana receives 14.25%. And I explained this when I explained the contract. I said, you can think of the contract as representing a pie, and I showed a pie chart divided into eight different segments. And Guyana receives 1/8 of a production each cycle, right? So out of 8 million barrels of oil, Guyana receives 1 million barrels of oil. And so far for 2020, up to the third quarter, three lifts were obtained. Guyana obtained 3 million barrels of oil, which meant the total production of oil was 8 times 3, 24 million barrels. And out of that, Guyana got $144.67 million. Now, if you calculate that based on the price of oil, the average price of oil over those three shipments, you get a price of about $45 per barrel. And $45 a barrel multiplied by 24 million barrels gives you $1.08 billion. And so now if you divided the amount of money Guyana received, which is $144.67 million, divide that by $1.08 billion, you get 13.4%. So Guyana received 13.4% of the production during the first three quarters. Now you might notice there's a difference between what I predicted. In other words, my calculation of the way the contract falls divides gives Guyana 14.25%. And when we calculate from the Bank of Guyana report, we get 13.4%. What is the difference? The difference is 0.85%. And it amounts to $9.18 million. In other words, $9,180,000 is the difference between what I calculated Guyana should have received and what we actually received. And the question is, what happened to that $9.18 million? Now, my guess is that that amounts to the operating costs. That is what Guyana paid in transaction fees to obtain the $144.67 million. But I don't know, right? Because this is just an estimate. Maybe it's a little more than $9 million that was lost. Maybe it's less than $9 million that was lost. But there's a difference of 0.85%. We received 13.4% of the profits of the production, the total production, from the first three quarters of 2020. So all these people who are claiming that Guyana only got 2% or would only get 2% of the production, they are lies. Why? Because 13.4% is what we actually received. And there are all those who said that Guyana should have signed a better contract, a royalty contract. I remember one accountant showing his math said that Guyana only got 8% of the total production based on his calculation. So what we did is I calculated what 8% would be. It turns out that 8% of the production is only $115 million. So if we had an 8% contract, we would have only received $115 million. If we had signed a 10% royalty only contract, we would have received for the entire year about $144 million. And if we signed a 12% contract, we would receive approximately $178 million. If we signed a 13% contract, we would have received about $187 million. But instead, we are getting for the entire year, all four quarters, about $190 million, which is what I quoted in the last video, right? You go back to that video where I talked about the GDP, Guyana's revenue from oil and the GDP for 2020. Guyana will get $190 million from oil this year, and that represents 14.25% of the production. Not 2%, not 8%, not 10%, not even 12%, but 14.25%. All right? So then there's another group of people who came out and said, well, Suriname got a better contract because Suriname got so many more percent in royalty and so many more percent in taxes and so on. The point is that when you calculate the total revenue that Guyana will get from this contract, given what we have already received, Guyana gets about the best in the industry. Guyana's contract meets the standards of the oil industry. So there should be no more dispute about whether Guyana signed a bad contract or a good contract. Guyana signed one of the best contracts in the oil industry today. We received 13.4% of revenue for the first three quarters, 13% of all that was produced in the first three quarters. And for this year, we will receive about $190 million, which represents more than 13% of the total revenue. What we should be doing is tracking down that difference of $9 million which is missing, but I'm going to leave that up to the journalists. They can go find out who's stealing money or how this money is being mismanaged so we lose $9 million in the first three quarters. But this is the point, guys. Guyana signed a good contract. It's a great contract. We received 13.4% in the first three quarters, 13% of total production in the first three quarters. So don't let me hear anyone else saying that this is a bad contract, that we only got 2%, and all the lies and from the politicians who use those lies to gain public office, they should be ashamed of themselves, because now the public is informed. They know that you are lying. Guyana did not sign a 2% contract. We got a 13.4%, got total 13.4% of production, and we got equivalent of 14.25% of all revenues from production. So there you have it, guys. That is the difference between the profit sharing contract and the royalty contract. We signed a profit sharing contract that gives us more revenue than any royalty contract we would have signed. And to prove that, we just analyzed the third quarter report from Bank of Guyana, which confirms that so far we have 13.4% of total production. You want to see more content like this? Click like and subscribe. In the comments below, tell me what you think about Guyana receiving 13.4% of total production for 2020, and whether in fact this contract is as good as any other contract out there, because now you can go compare it, right? No longer have to listen to all of the propaganda. You have actual facts and figures that you can now compare. Tell me what you think, guys. Remember, you can share this video with friends and family around the world. Let people know what's happening in Georgetown, Guyana. Later!